two sons. To one, father says, go to the vineyard. He says, yes, yes, I will. And he didn't go. And to another, he says, go. He, no, I will not go. Then he changed his mind and went. That's when we say no, there is a chance to say yes. And there will be nothing to be ashamed of. But if we said yes, then we no longer have a chance to say no without losing your face. The Apostle James has a wonderful example. A huge ship, and is controlled by the steering wheel. Mighty strong horse, and put the reins in his mouth, and he is controlled by it. So we are guided by our language. And blessed is the man who doesn't sin in word. Such a person can override himself, rethink himself. We usually think about something big, about great exploits, prayer, fasting, vigil, but probably the most important and most difficult, curb your tongue, so that our answer are either yes or no. But to be yes is yes, and to no is no. And this will insist our inner truth. It's through this that we live from the deceit, which we ask to the Lord to get rid of.